वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल. आई वेलकम यू ऑल टुडे फॉर वर्चुअल सिटी मीटिंग्स ऑन हाउ टू इनकॉर्पोरेट अ प्राइवेट लिमिटेड कंपनी विथ प्री एंड पोस्ट कंप्लायंस अलॉन्ग विद रिसेंट एमसीए रिलैक्सेशन बाय अवर स्टूडेंट रिनाउंड फैकल्टी सीएपीबी सतीश कुमार फ्रॉम आंध्र प्रदेश. सो फर्स्टली आई विल रिक्वेस्ट टू रेज योर राइट हैंड ऑन हार्ट फॉर मोटो सॉन्ग इन ऑनर ऑफ मोटो सॉन्ग. Thank you all. I would like to request branch Gandhidham branch chairman Sri Janish Patel for his welcome address. Over to Janish bhai.
Very good afternoon. Today's chief guest CS Srinivasan Joshi sir, chairman of Corporate Law and Corporate Governance Committee ICEI. Today's faculty CA PV Satish Kumar sir, CA Hardik Patel chairman of Anand branch of WRC of ICEI, CA Ramesh Pindoria chairman of Bhuj branch of WRC of ICEI. Senior members, managing committee members of Anand, Bhuj and Gandhidham branch, and all my dear friends. I, on behalf of Gandhidham, Anand and Bhuj branch of WRC of ICEI, welcomes today's chief guest, CA Srinivasan Joshi sir, and today's faculty, PV Satish Kumar sir. Thank you very much, sir, for devoting your valuable time for our members. Dear friends, hope all of you and your family are at home and safe. As we all know, we are facing crucial times since last 1 year due to corona pandemic. I know it is normal to feel fearful and worried during the difficult times, but by diverting our mind to some activities indoor as well as sharing our thoughts and concern with our friends will help us to be positive. We all are one big family and our branch is always ready to help out in whatever way possible for our members, students and their families. Moving away towards the seminar, topic for today is how to incorporate a private limited company with pre and post compliance along with recent MC relaxation. Friends, nowadays, as we all know, private limited company has become quite favorable to the businesses. Its incorporation and various compliance are normal queries which is asked by our clients along with tax compliance applicability. This webinar will cover all of such queries and laws, and also due to COVID situation, what relaxation has been granted to the companies. We hope that the webinar will help our members in day-to-day activities. Thank you very much. Over to you, Sanjay bhai.
Thank you, Janish sir. Now I would like to request Sri Hardik Patel, Anand branch chairman, for his welcome address. Over to Hardik bhai.
Sanjay ji, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Respected chairman CA Jainesh bhai, Gandhidham branch, chairman CA Ramesh bhai, Bhuj branch, vice chairman and secretary CA Hiral, Anand branch, MOC and vice chairman CA Sanjay, Gandhidham branch, CA Purvi Doshi, chairperson Vikasa Bhuj branch. Our most valued invited chief guest and our own CA Srinivas Y. Joshi sir, today's faculty, CA PV Satish Kumar sir, seniors in the professions, managing committee members, my colleagues and students. Good afternoon to one and all. It's my absolute honor and pleasure to address you all. And I welcome you all on today's virtual CPA meeting on incorporation of a private limited company with pre and post compliances along with recent MCA relaxations. Today we have with us CAPV Satish Kumar sir, and I am sure we all will be benefited by this lecture. Wish you all a very happy learning. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Hardik bhai. I would like to request further Ramesh Pindoria, Bhuj branch chairman, for his address.
Respected chief guest of today's VCM, Srinivas Joshi sir, speaker of today's VCM, CA PV Satish Kumar sir, chairmen of Bhuj Gandhidham and Anand branch, CA Jainish Patel, CA Hardik Patel, and all committee members of all the three branches, Bhuj Gandhidham and Anand branch, and all the members who have joined in this VCM. On behalf of all the three branches, we warmly welcome all of you in this VCM. Topic of this VCM is very much important for all of us, and that's why we have received overwhelming response for this seminar, and we have to close the registration in today morning. I am sure all the members who have joined in this VCM will enjoy throughout this session. Once again, on behalf of all the three organizing branches, we welcome all of you in this VCA. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Ramesh bhai. Now I would like to request our today's chief guest, Sri Srinivas Joshi sir, for his special address to our members. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good afternoon to all. Jainesh Patel, the chairman of Gandhidham, along with Sanjay, Hardik ji with Hiral for Anand branch, and Ramesh ji for Bhuj, and all the team, elected members, and all my friends. And of course, Satish Kumar ji, who is expert faculty. I being a chairman of CLCGC, that is Corporate Law and Corporate Governance Committee, we are always on the lookout of persons like Satish ji, who would deliver lectures throughout India, because this is a very difficult topic. Very few people are into this today, if you see chartered accountants. I'll talk about it a little later, but I congratulate sir for helping us, branches, even smaller branches. And there are some speakers, I must say, at the beginning of this, that they ask us how many people are attending. If 5 or 50, I will not come. I'm good for 500. So that is the, the way people deal. Of course, in Western region, when I was elected for 9 years, we used to keep out such people who ask. Even Saradaji has never asked us whether 5 people will attend or 50 or 500. And Saradaji used to give lecture as many as there were physical attendance was. Anyway, thanks a lot, Satishji, for being with us. At the outset, I must say that this particular very difficult time that all of us are coming together, the branch activities in CSR type activities have changed because the many are raising funds and giving oxygen. If you see Delhi, it's so bad that CCMs, RCMs, all are after oxygen, and they are given, the ambulances and all and whatnot there. So it is the whole CSR for branches is changing a lot, or the office, regional offices is changing a lot with shortage of oxygen, hospital beds and medicines. Actually, there is a big fear in the mind. And this fear is not necessarily only about the life. That fear is always there. People don't want to go out. Gujarat is much better than other states, I hope. But other states, some of them are very bad, including Maharashtra, where I stay. So this is really, or Delhi, or some of the state like Kerala. So, but here the question is of fear of some of the state. But real fear is in the profession today as to how my practice will grow. How I'll survive. Some of them are senior people are trying to say that we'll close down. We are not able to survive. In some of the states, when we interact at CCM, they say that no, this is not, the times will survive for two reasons. One is that everything is locked down. They are unable to run their offices on one side. And secondly, technology is hitting them very hard. Technological developments are hitting very hard, the senior professionals. And at the same time, who should take up technology, friends? The junior members who are going in the industry. If you see 90% of those pass or 95% go in industry, who will take up technology? The seniors need handholding with juniors for technology, and juniors need handholding for, knowledge and experience of seniors. Otherwise, firms can't run. We cannot run in this current situation or in the future also with the advent of technology. So everybody is worried. One is of life in few states, but many are worried about the future of the profession or future of many of the partnerships which are happening. And in such cases, we always think of solutions. Friends, I feel the solution generally, if you ask me, is networking, automation, and specialization. If you have three words with you, I think everything is said in that. Just by networking, you can have cost sharing or knowledge sharing or common best practices or common IT infrastructure, common quality control, specialization, even automation is possible if there is a combination of more people. We'll talk on networking. There is a networking guideline issued recently by ICI, and I think there should be a separate session on that. Jay Chairaji was the head of that group, and I think we can invite him to speak either, or he can be chairman of the session. Anyone else will deliver at that point. But it is one of the things we must consider in the current period. Now, coming to my committee and today's subject, friends, here there is a complete loss of interest of CA community in corporate laws. If you see, I am myself a chartered accountant and a company secretary, which I passed several decades back, both. And I was doing the practice of CS as a CS and company law practice. Now here today, you are looking at new avenues. There is no need to look at new avenues. Company law, all of us have learned. Company corporate law, we already know. LLP, we already, what we don't know there. And why we are giving practice to chartered secretary, even though I'm a company secretary practicing the chartered accountant, but I always feel why our profession is losing on that. That's why I complimented Satish Kumarji for being with us and telling us about this particular, you know, incorporation or starting a practice or even increasing our practice in this area. And as a CLCC chairman this year, I obviously I would be interested in anyone who comes forward for the subjects being taught and subjects being taken up by this. I will request all of you to go on two things of CLCGC site. Friends, one is we are having weekly announcement. Weekly, or even yesterday we had an announcement on forms where the dates have been increased and no penalties being charged. So every day or earlier alternate day, you'll find some announcement coming from CLCGC. Like, you know, you only know that GST committee or indirect committee has to do daily. No. Even corporate law, even direct tax, all are working in the industry and there are updates. This committee updates, I'll request you to see two places. One is weekly announcement and secondly, monthly newsletter. We are having a summary of all the announcement of the whole month summarized there. These amendments, I mean, monthly in the newsletter, we cover all the amendments to notifications, circulars, orders, etc. and make give even the link to original circulars on our website. And this is available on ICA website. And I will, of course, you will have programs on recent changes in Schedule 3, audit report, accounting rule, auditing rule, remuneration to independent director, etc. You will have. But always remember not to rush into it. Satish ji is more, into it, and he will tell us whatever subjects we should take should be relevant to that period. For example, all these amendments are applicable in 22 March audits. So rushing through right now will confuse us whether we will be doing it in 21 reports which you are still to sign, still to audit, or 22. And we will suppose I start speaking on CARO 2020. CARO 2020 is applicable in 22, not in 21. And moment, I have to still go by CARO 16. So whenever you are arranging programs, even though the committee wants you to be updated, update them at right time. The time is after October for all this, you know, CARO 20 or Schedule 3 or accounting rule, auditing rule. The right time should be there to update so that our members would study. I will request you to update, but here you have to. It is like, you know, parking in the mind. Yeah, this is an amendment for next year. I will just go through it and later on read it. I will request you instead to go through our mail of 7th May given by CLCGC to all branches where we have listed huge number of topics. But when Satish ji is there or someone like him, we can always take advantage and add to those topics. Whatever the committee has suggested, we can have 4 or 5 days updation programs on that, which are current laws. Another thing I'll request you is to suggest speakers on all these committees where we need good speakers and good persons who would support us in many ways. One is about the speakers. Second is about the various groups that are being formed by all the committees of ICI. We also form groups regularly, first to see the new law, if it is LLP law came, and that time also we had come. So any new law. Second is for amending the law, we have groups. Then another thing is there are publications of various committees, including our committee. We upgrade them or we create new publication based on new topics. Suppose women director, you will have a publication. So some such new publication or old publication are upgraded, and we need people who understand the subject and who can be part of such groups. Say, I'll request all of you that if you can tell us some of the names, you know, your expertise will be at national level useful to the whole profession. If you can really contribute to that, doesn't need to contribute like, you know, elected members. Elected members of branches, regions and central are working 24/7. But it is not required for the groups. Group can work for a particular project and go out. So you can always do that. Those who are interested in becoming independent directors, we have IICA. In the Indian Institute of Corporate Affairs. And this, we are having a collaboration and having several programs with them on that. And we can pass exam also. We are teaching. We have videos on that to teach you how to pass that exam on our website. So you can take part in creating videos. You can take part in, you know, but otherwise, if you want to become independent director, such videos should be looked at. I will request you to look at several existing publications issued, just last year by our committee. One is on related party transaction, extremely important from audit point of view for us. Another publication last year was Section 144. Again, what is management, service and all is a very difficult subject, and what you cannot do. And really, you should read as to what is banned. What is why the fee cannot be more than the audit fee. You should read that. And there are several exemptions to that. I mean, everybody is confused. It is not so. For example, tax audit fee is not covered in that equal amount or other charges. So 144, you should read. The guide to board report. We write board report for many private limited companies in our office without understanding the content of board report. If Satish Kumarji starts talking about board report, 2 hours will be less only on board report content. Yes. It is so huge, so huge. I mean, the requirement. And we hardly do anything in our office. Friend, Schedule 3, Division 1, 2, 3. One is normal for small accounts, and Division 2 is for Ind AS, 3 for NBFC. All publications are available. FAQs are available on LLP. I was requesting you to start, give a program on LLP. There are FAQs on LLP. We can cover that in a program. And another thing, even though it is not directly related, I'm a vice chairman at two places. One is I'm vice chairman of AASB. Several good publications are there. And also I'm a deputy convener of CAQ, that is Center for Audit Quality. We have issued an audit quality maturity model. We'll come out with that on 1st July. I request you to use those audit manuals, checklists. I will give you something I'll tell you here, because audit quality and audit is always related to company law, what we are talking about. So here I'll say that we are having a separate committee for members in practice, which is developing audit tools free for the profession. So we will have audit checklists, we'll have audit manuals, and we'll have audit tools free available to all of us very soon, within say next 3-4 months. So I think we should see that our audit delivery is really good. Friends, the company law, which we are talking about, the large companies, listed company, there are too many frauds all over the world. I'm not blaming our own country. There are frauds all over the world. And our audit quality is in question. We have accounting standard board, auditing standard board, internal audit standard board, local government standing boards giving us standards. Then we have financial reporting review board, peer review board, quality review board, checking whether what we are doing is right or not. And last is the disciplinary. Are we really giving quality? No. I have been in all these boards. And then I know that it's very pathetic. It's very pathetic. We must go on technology in future. We must go on technology, friends. And unless technology is used in audit, we are not going to succeed. Whatever we learn in company, corporate law, LLP, GST, income tax, use technology. And it's a mindset. It's a mindset to get technology and use it. You know, we say it's costly. It's the same cost which was 10 years back when chartered accountant was available 10,000, now 40,000 minimum in any city. The cost of technology is same. In fact, it's reducing. We must think as a SMP whether we can use technology in audit, technology in every law that I understand. It's easy to find in company law, you give a particular phrase, you will get all the places where that phrase is used in company law. I mean, this is the way you study the subject under technology. I will request you as a chairman, CLCJC, to use different method of study of a law. If you can do that, really. And I'll request, of course, the speaker today to guide us generally on this before he starts on a subject, and so that we are all benefited. I'm extremely thankful to Vice Chairman Sanjay Ji and Chairman Ji, both for inviting me here, Jainish Ji, to invite me here. And Hardik and, of course, Ramesh Ji have to approve that I should be here. So for all of them to say yes. And I hope I'll be guide to all of you in future as well, whenever possible. With that, thanks a lot for giving me opportunity. Thank you, friends. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for your golden words to enlighten our members. Thank you, sir. Further, I would like to request CA Hiral Prajapati, Vice Chairman Anand Branch, for introduction of our today's faculty.
Thank you, Sanjay. Jai Bharat. It is my great pleasure to introduce today's learned faculty, C.A. Satish Kumar. He is a practicing chartered accountant working as a partner in Subharayudhu and Company Chartered Accountants. His core area of practice is corporate and income tax. As a student, he secured All India 9th rank in C.A. CPT and was the student vice chairman on behalf of Vijayawada branch of Sikasa of ICI for the year 2009 and 2010. He has given various lectures at ICI Forum and other similar professional bodies. He has also cleared ICWA, CS and MBA. He is a certified concurrent auditor of bank, certified forensic account and fraud detector, certified public finance and government accountant, and also holder of a certificate of course on GST by ICI. He is a regular paper writer for Vijayawada branch CA newsletter. With this brief word, welcome you, sir.
Thank you, Hilbhai. Now I would like to request our today's faculty, C. Satish Kumar, to start our technical session. Over to Satish.
Good evening, members, and good evening to the chief guest, Srinivas Joshi, sir. First, I would like to say that the whole world is suffering with this COVID-19 pandemic, second wave. And I express my saddened and deepened heart to convey the deepest condolences to the bereaved family, our own professional colleagues, friends of family and relatives. Thank you. Thank you for an excellent introduction by Hiral sir. And thank you, the chairman and the vibrant committee members of the three branches, Gandhidham branch, Anand branch, and Bus branch. And a special thanks to Sanjay Ji, the vice chairman of the Gandhidham branch, for giving me this wonderful opportunity to learn and share a knowledge with you all for the second time. So in fact, this is my second presentation in Gandhidham branch. Actually, the first one is on Sanjay Ji's birthday. It's on 18th, 2020 July. Am I right, Sanjay Ji?
Yes, you are right.
Thank you. So, sir, Chief Guest, sir, Srinivas, sir, I took a word, sir, and I'll maximum try my presentation today to run practically through the MCA website so that it will be technically enlightening the members, so that even I will be learning from all the learned members from you, sir. So before starting my presentation, I request organizer to share the, I'll just share my screen. Just a second, please hold on. Yeah. Before starting my presentation in a virtual conference, I would like to ask three things. Am I visible?
Yes.
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes.
And is my screen visible?
Yes, perfectly.
Yeah. Thank you. And I am just starting my presentation. Yeah. Today, our topic is how to incorporate a private limited company with a pre and post compliances along with recent MCA relaxations. Just a second. Sanjay ji, these are all waiting persons, I hope so. It's distracting the screen.
Okay, wait a while.
Is there any option to just minimize them? Or if you see just waiting room, approve all the members.
So you can approve and...
Yeah. So I just want to proceed.
Yes, you can proceed.
Yeah. Today's topic, I just want to say how to incorporate a private limited company practically as per the chief guest, suggestion with the pre and post compliances. And that is before incorporation, what are the requirements to be collected? And after incorporation, what are the preliminary compliances should be done? And along with the recent MCA relaxation, considering this COVID-19 pandemic. And moving forward, I know that when any person starts a business, there will be many thoughts in our mind. And one such question comes to our mind is whether to incorporate a private limited company or not. Okay, let me discuss in detail in the coming slides what is exactly this is. I'll just let you know what are the benefits of a private limited company, what are the requirements to incorporate a private limited company, and what is the procedure for incorporation of a private limited company. Moving forward, we shall just discuss first the benefits of a private limited company. Though these are not an exhaustive list, these are just a glimpse of the benefits, maybe most important than any other benefits of a private limited company. The first one is minimum capital. The first benefit is the minimum capital, wherein there is no such requirement of a minimum capital for incorporation of a private limited company. Erstwhile, there is a minimum requirement of 1 lakh paid-up capital for incorporating a private limited company. And now such a requirement is discarded with, and we can start even with a minimum of 2 rupees at a private limited company incorporation. The second benefit is the private limited company has a limited liability. Let me explain you this benefit with an example. For suppose there is X private limited company which has debt owned funds, and for some of the reasons it has undergone some financial distress. When the private limited company has undergone some financial distress, the members of the company, say for suppose Mr. A is a member of the private limited company and his share in the private limited company is only 20 lakh rupees, and already he has paid 16 lakhs into the private limited company, then he needs to pay only the balance 4 lakhs at this time, and he is no way concerned with the company's debt. That is, he is limited to the liability of his unpaid share in the capital. This is the second important benefit. The third one is the fundraising by the private limited company is very smoother. I would say not only just private limited company, then even the public limited company, it is not an exception, such as venture capitalists or angel investors are ready to flow their funds into the private limited company. The fourth benefit is very easy transfer of shares. Let me explain. Free and easy transfer of shares mean, unlike any other concern or entity or such as a proprietary concern or a partnership firm, in a private limited company, the share transfers can be easily done amongst the members of the company or any outsiders just by giving their share certificates and all. So this is one more major benefit. The fifth one is uninterrupted existence. There is one word, perpetual succession. If you remember, perpetual succession means a private limited company has a separate legal entity wherein any member, even though a deceased or for such cancer, if he resigns, even then the private limited company will not be halted and it shall continue. It has an uninterrupted existence. This is a major benefit. Next one is the foreign direct investments are allowed. That is, any foreign person or any foreign corporate entity can make 100% FDI investment into a private limited company with some conditions by FEMA. Next one, next and last and the most important benefit is it builds credibility. What is meant by credibility? A private limited company is free to is free for all to see its public documents. Once, if everyone can see the public documents by paying the requisite fee to the ROC, then the credibility and trustworthiness of such entity will be very transparent and everyone will be interested to invest in such a concern. I'll just come out with an live thing, how to check the public documents. Just bear with me. If you just click here, the view public document, we'll just route through the MCA website. After routing in through the MCA website, if you can just log into the MCA website with our credentials. If we just log in with our credentials into the MCA website by filling the company details with which we just want to for which we need to see the public documents, it will be visible here. See, these are all the details. By paying the requisite fee of just a nominal amount of rupees 100, it will be very easy to see the public documents of any private limited company. Here I am just restricting myself to see, for restricting myself with respect to private limited company only. Moving forward, before dealing with the incorporation procedure, I just want to enlighten you what is the transformation procedure which has happened in the last decade with respect to incorporation of private limited companies. Erstwhile, before 2014, there used to be Companies Act 1956, wherein for name reservation, we used to file Form 1A, and for incorporation, Form 1-18-32. I hope you all remember, if you just practice at that time, the incorporation procedures. Later on, when Companies Act 2013 has come into effect from 1st April 2014, the forms has been slightly revised, wherein Form INC1 was used to reserve the name, and later on, INC7, INC22, and DR12 were used to file for incorporation. And then step by step, then INC29 has come in 2015, and then a spice INC32 has come in 2017, which was the starting seed for now, which we are talking about SPICE plus the incorporation procedure, SPICE INC32, wherein we used to fill the SPICE INC32 form along with INC33, the MOA, INC34, the AOA, and later on, the Agile and Run forms have been come into picture, wherein Agile used for registering the GST, Run used for reserve unique name. That means you, Run services, which is a web-based, can be used for reserving your company name. Later on, by mixing all these, a new form called SPICE Plus has been introduced from February 15, 2020, from 23rd February 2020, which was replacing the SPICE. This e-form was introduced as an integrated form. Okay, let us discuss in detail about this SPICE Plus. Yeah, this is SPICE Plus integrated web form. Web form, please note this point, it is a web form wherein I'll just let you know what exactly is the terminology web form. SPICE means simplified proforma for incorporating company electronically. Yeah. Moving forward, the SPICE Plus can be divided into two parts. Part A and Part B. Spice Plus Part A deals with reservation of a name, which is through integrated web form itself. That is, through web form itself, we can reserve the name of a company. After just Part A, then we can proceed with Part B, which has a boutique of services, namely, I have 9 services are being provided by Spice Plus Part B along with Part A. These are the 9 services. 1, incorporation. 2, DIN allotment. 3, mandatory issue of PAN. 4, mandatory issue of TAN. 5, mandatory issue of EPF for registration. Mandatory issue of ECSI. Mandatory issue of profession tax registration mandate. It will be applicable only to the state of Maharashtra. 7, 8, mandatory opening of bank account. And last, but not the least, allotment of GSTN, if it is applicable. Allotment of GSTN is only applicable. We shall just discuss in detail each and everything in the upcoming slides. Yeah, which I was discussing, what is this web-based form? What is this web-based form and what needs to be done initially for availing the incorporation services through Spice Plus, which is a web form? It is an online screen, it facilitates on-screen filing and real-time data validation for seamless incorporation of a companies. What I mean exactly is, it is post-login services and no form is required for compiling this Spice Plus. I'll just tell you practically how to visit this web form. If you just log into the MCA portal, if you just log in here, or without login, I'll just let you know where exactly this is. After login, here it is, Spice Plus. This is a web-based form. And these services can be utilized only by logging into the MCA website. We shall discuss in detail about these, how to utilize these services in the coming slides. Yeah, this is the thing which I was discussing. When we click the MCA services, here in the MCA services dashboard, home, MCA, acts and rules, the Spice Plus is a link which is a web-based form. In the dashboard, we can see a new application or an existing application. If it is a new application, we can proceed accordingly. If it is an existing application, we will edit all the forms which needs to be pre-filled for the upload. Dear members, please bear with me as my chief guest has suggested me to just go through practically. So I'm just sharing both the screenshots as well as practically I want to explain everyone how it exactly appears. So first thing is Spice Part A, which we already discussed. Spice Plus Part A is helpful for reserving the name of the company. Okay, so before going into the Spice Plus aspects, what are the requirements that needs to be collected well in advance so that at the time of filling the form, it will be useful. Only 2 requirements are required for filling up the Part A of Spice Plus, wherein first one is, ask the 2 unique names in the order of priority. Number 1, what is the name? Number 2, what is the name? Number 1, number 2, that is the order of priority, and a brief objects, just 2-3 lines, a brief objects of the company, which should be replicated at the time of incorporation in detail with the objects, so that there should be in consonance and there should not be any mismatch, which might be a cause and reason for rejection of the Spice Plus form. On clicking this one, we'll just log in to the MCA portal so that we can just know what exactly, how to fill this Spice Plus Part A. Yeah, I'm just logging into the MCA portal with my credentials. Everyone should be having these credentials, otherwise they can't proceed with the Spice Plus or anything else. KYC forms, any web-based form needs to be done only through post-login services. As I said you earlier, here in the MCA service dashboard, if you click Spice Plus, Here there is two options, whether you want to file a new application or you want to proceed with an existing application. I'm very fresh. I just want to incorporate a private limited company now through Part A. So I want to go with new application wherein Part A has been enabled. For your references, I already filled some Spice Plus form so that it will be easy for you to deal with. See, this is the company which I have filled in, wherein this Part A, Spice Plus. Just don't read this Spice Plus Part B and all. This all will be highlighted only after Part A thing only. So for your reference only, I have filled this Part A. Yeah. This Spice Plus Part A. Here, the first one which will be asked is the type of the company. It is whether it is a new company or a Section 8 company or LLP or any others or unlimited producer company, OPC, everything. So as we confine ourselves to today's topic of private limited company, here for a private limited company incorporation, new company others needs to be selected. Yeah, then it will ask the class of the company, whether it is public or private or such kind. As we are going with the private limited company, we will just go with the private, and then category, whether it is limited by shares or limited by guarantee. We have selected the company limited by shares, and the subcategory, whether it is a government company, non-government company, any Section 8 company or so and so like that, it will be asking. So we need to select a non-government company if it's the case maybe, and then according to the objects, the industrial activity code needs to be selected. Sir, where these objects will be visible? Okay, let me explain. If you just come back to the Spice Plus, here there is a detailed instruction kit of Spice Plus, Agile Pro, everything, which we will discuss in detail. As of now, the industrial code, for the industrial code, we'll just, if we just click this, a file will be Spice Plus file will be opened. A field wise, we can just analyze. Just want the codes from 1 to 100. The codes will be there in the Spice Plus. Yeah, these are the codes from 1 to 20. These are the codes, and and for suppose I am just, hello? Hello? Sir, am I audible?
Yes, yes, we're audible.
Yeah, yeah, thank you. Some disturbances. Yes, thank you. Yeah, according to the instruction kit provided by Spice Plus, we are going with a mining company. We are incorporating a mining company in my illustrative case, wherein with respect to mining division, the activity code is number 14. If we just enter number 14, the description of the main division will be pre-filled into the description box. Later on, we shall just give the summary of the objects. We need to give just 2 to 3 lines, because as this is for demo purpose, I have written only one line, but we need to give 2 to 3 lines at least. Later on, as we have already discussed in our earlier slide, the requirements, in the order of priority, two unique names needs to be given in the order of priority. Means first I have written Jaya Kamakshi. Second, if you have confidence that only one name will be selected for, will be approved for you, you can go with only one name. Otherwise, you can go with two names. If first name is not allotted, then second name will be allotted to you. How to check whether the availability of name is correct or not? Don't worry. For members' convenience, I have just broke my presentations into various facts issued by the MCA so that it will be convenient for us to analyze everything. Excuse me. Thank you. Yeah, I'm just I hope I could able to explain you SPICE plus part A. After SPICE plus part A, if you just sign out this session. This is what which we have discussed. And if you just fill the SPICE plus part A, these are the things. And if you just see the SPICE plus part A form, there is attachment symbol right at the beneath of the form, wherein sometimes we need to give some attachments. In what cases such attachments needs to be given, I'll just discuss with you. This is one of the frequent asked question, wherein is it mandatory for every company to follow the SPICE plus process for incorporation of a company? Yes, it's mandatory from 23rd February 2020 for every company through incorporate through SPICE plus itself. Next one, moving forward, can part A of web form be filed separately? Means, can I just reserve the unique name first, or should I proceed with the incorporation? Here we can see, if we just fill the form part A, and if we go to the next page, this kind of screen will be appear, wherein it will be asking, if you want to submit for name reservation, you can proceed by name reservation by paying the requisite fee of just a nominal 1,000 rupees or so, and you can and wait for approval. Otherwise, you can proceed for incorporation, that is by proceeding to part B and so on the respective forms. But practically, what I suggest is you just go first part A. Once the name gets approved, then only you should please request you to go to further forms, because if the name itself gets rejected, then the entire form, there are chances for the entire form getting to be resubmitted or rejected. So what I advise you is part A approval and then part B and so on like that. See, SPICE plus part A, submit for name reservation, or proceed for SPICE plus part B for incorporation. Then what will happen in case the proposed name is identical or too nearly resembles with the name of an existing limited liability partnership or an existing company? So before everyone want to go with the proposed name for incorporation, they should inquire the name through MCA website. This is the procedure to just inquire the name. I'm just clicking on the link. I'm just routed to the MCA website. Here, MCA services dashboard, check company name. So check company name. Here we just want to enter. Here I am just going with some J. Kamakshi or so. If I just enter here the Kamakshi, I'll be knowing which are all the companies available with the word Kamakshi. See, 128 results have been found in various states across India with the word Kamakshi, that they might have started with that company name, or the name has been included in any other company name. So there are many chances for rejection of our form. So everyone, before going for incorporation or filling the part A, should check the in MCA services how to inquire the name, and should know the whether the name is available with them or not. So moving forward, the next one is, how do I apply for a name if the proposed name includes the name of a trademark? It's true. Such kind of cases also will happen, because there may be cases where our name, our proposed name might have been already registered under trademark by any other person across or India, or by any other entity or India. So we need to check whether our name has been registered with trademark or not. If we just go with the same link under check name company, check company name, if we just scroll down here it is visible, check trademark. If we just click the check trademark, here we can see whether the word contains or match with anything whether it is start our proposed name, if it starts the trademark, or if it contains with the trademark, or if it matches with the trademark, then there are chances for getting resubmitted. At that time, I'll just let you know what is the procedure needs to be followed. Here, I told you that in part A, at the beneath, there is an option of attachment. We, in the regular conditions, there is no form needs to be attached. But if any of our proposed name is matching with the trademark, then we should get a no objection certificate from that concerned entity that, that I have got no objection to use my company's name by you for incorporation. But friends, practically, it's not at all possible because no person will give his no objection certificate because he is so particular that if he has registered with trademark means he is so particular with that name. Moving forward, the next one is, what are the words or expressions which can be used only after obtaining prior approval of central government? Friends, there are certain key or coined words for, which can't be used in the proposed name without the prior approval of any of our central government, such as these are the key or some coined words: board, commission, authority, undertaking, national, etc. Everything. After this presentation, I'll just share this PPT as well, and the recordings also will be there so that you can just see in detail. Otherwise, you can just go refer the frequently asked questions issued by the MCA so that you will be knowing which are the words which require a prior approval of a central government. Moving forward, in the case, the proposed name indicates different words like finance, leasing, cheat funds, investment, securities, or combination thereof, whereas the proposed objects of the company do not indicate such activities, what would be the case? Friends, the name should be in consonance with the objects of the company. If you just keep one name, it should resemble the objects of the company. You should not keep whatever the name which is required for you, because there are high chances of rejection if it is not matched with the objects of the company. So, compiling all this discussion, I just prepared one slide wherein there, what are the precautions should one take before applying for the proposed name. So, proposed name shouldn't be identical or resembled or phonetical with any other names. If so, there are chances for rejection. Next, if the proposed name includes the words which are registered under trademark, I just told you what are the situations or what might be the case where it matches with the trademark and what are the consequences needs to be done if it matches with the trademark. The third one is, if the proposed name doesn't match with the wrong class or category, then there are chances of rejection. Wrong class or category means, if you just remember the part A of Spice E Plus, there we have mentioned the category or class of the company. So according to the class of the company only, the name should resemble. If there is any mismatch, then there are chances of rejection. Next, the proposed name shouldn't indicate the word finance, investment, capital, holding, insurance, etc. And some other names as we already dealt in the previous slide. The proposed name, as we already discussed, the proposed name should be in consonance with the objects of the firm and it shouldn't be vague. And the proposed name shouldn't contain any commonly used words such as a, the, is, was, any common words. If such kind of words are used as a coined word, then there are major chances of getting rejected. The last one, but not the least, the proposed name shouldn't contain the name of foreign country or city or town, etc. Just a second. Some slides. Sanjay ji, I think some other host is writing these pictures because I am not dealing with this. I just request that host to erase these so that it can be an obstacle for the slides.
Okay, wait a while.
Yeah. I'm just erasing, Sanjay ji, wait. Yeah, I just erased everything. Yeah, moving forward, these are some precautions that needs to be taken by one who is going to incorporate a private limited company, that is Spice Plus Party, while reserving a name of the company. These precautions needs to be taken care, otherwise there are high chances for getting your name getting rejected. Yeah, moving forward, can an approved name or reserved using party of Spice Plus form one, Spice Plus form one application ID at MCA portal be permitted to be filed at part B of Spice Plus form from other applicant ID? Let me explain you this question in other way. If I suppose through MCA portal, which I have logged in, I just showed you now, I filled the part A. Can any one of you guys can fill the part B and proceed for incorporation? No, you can't proceed because both part A and part B should be done with the same ID in the same MCA website with the same ID so that it can proceed for incorporation. This question means. And recently, on January 26, 2021, MCA has come up with an option of extending our name approved letter. That is, how can a name reserved through Spice Plus Part A be extended in line with Rule 9A of other of the company's rules 2014? Yes, there is an option of extension. Initially, for a period of just 20 days, our name gets approved will be only valid for only 20 days. Within this 20 days, the entire incorporation procedure should be uploaded. The incorporation documents need not be approved, but from our side, the document needs to be uploaded within that 20 days. But for many reasons which are not in our hands, the 20 days may not be sufficient for many of the members. So keeping this compliance in mind, the MCA has come with an option of extension. Wherein, if you just see the slide here, if you just click the extend button here, it will ask, sir, what is the period of extension, which one? Sir, whether it is up to 40 days or whether it is directly up to 60 days. Okay, up to 40 days you have selected. Then you just want to proceed by paying some extra amount up to 60 days. So up to 40 days is one option. 40 to 60 days is second option. 20 to directly 60 days is third option. But how much is the fees needs to be paid? What is the fee payable for extension of name reservation? Okay. If you want to go from 20 to 40 days, the 1000 rupees is the fee needs to be paid if you want to extend. If well before 40 days, okay, you came to know that, okay, within 40 days also I'm unable to incorporate. I just want to further extend to 60 days. Then pay 2000. At the time of 20 days expiry of the 20 days itself, you thought that might not be, even 40 days also might not be sufficient. Then directly you can proceed to extension for 60 days by paying a requisite fee of 3000. Until that expiry of 60 days, your part one will be still valid for continuing with part B of the incorporation. So this is which we have discussed today. When the name gets approved, what is the process to fill part B? Once part A gets approved, then automatically it directs to part B. There is an importance in this question, wherein if you remember earlier, while reserving a name, an SRN will be generated, and day by day and daily, on day we need to check the status of the SRN, whether it is approved or whether it is pending or whether it is rejected, so on. Only once it gets approved, then you can proceed for incorporation. But as this party is an integrated web form, integral web form, then there is no question of generating of SRN. Once, if you submit for name reservation, the party will be showing the status, whether it has been approved or rejected or it is still pending. Once the party is approved, then you can proceed for filling of Part B. So we can go with Part B now. As of now, Part A has been discussed in detail, and now we know that how to incorporate a private limited company by reserving a unique name with Party Auspice E Plus. Moving forward, I just want to tell you the requirements of Spice Plus Part B. As we have already done away with the Party Auspice Plus, the second one, if you just remember my second slide here, the first one, the benefits were already dealt. Now the second, the requirements of Party, the two unique names required, the brief objects of the company is required for Party A. These are the two requirements of Party A. Now, what are the requirements for Part B? I'm just letting you know the details of the requirements of a Spice Plus well in before, because if a person wants to go for any incorporation, if you make all these requirements well in advance, so that it will be easy for you to just upload the incorporated documents well in advance, that well is well within that 20 days time limit. And with this electronic form, even a company can be incorporated in 2 or 3 days itself if every document is perfect. Okay, let me discuss with this Spice Plus Part B. What are the requirements for Spice Plus Part B? And please note, dear members, please mark my word, digital signature of every director and subscriber is mandatory for incorporation of this private limited company. Digital signature is a kind of a pen drive. Then I know that every member are aware about the digital signature. Now it's class 3 digital signature. For class 3 digital signature, one self-attested Aadhaar card is required, one self-attested PAN card is required, and one passport size photo is required of the proposed director and subscriber. And after collecting these details, and depending upon the whether it is e-mudra or SIFI or what might be the case, depending on them, the digital signature will be approved. And once the digital signature comes to the director's digital signature come into our hand, then we can proceed with further requirements. Further requirements for Spice Plus Part B. First one, we should know what is the authorized capital. Authorized capital means what is the ceiling, what is the maximum level to which a private limited company's capital can be floated with. So for suppose if it is 10 lakhs or 15 lakhs, 20 lakhs, I think until 15 lakhs, there is a relaxation by the government that until 15 lakhs, there is no fee needs to be paid, above 15 lakhs, such kind of fee. So we need to check the ceiling of the authorized capital. From authorized capital, what is the paid up capital? From the authorized capital, what is the paid up capital? And who are the number of promoters? That is two directors, two subscribers, or all the directors or some subscribers. Everything should be dealt in detail at the time of requirement, so that while filling the requisite application, it will be easy to you. Next one is you should know the shareholding pattern, if it is 2 persons, whether it is 50-50, 3 persons, whether it is 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, or 20-40, like that. Everything, it should be dealt in detail at the time. You need to right at the requirements stage itself, so that it will be easy for you at the time of filling the application. Next, we should know the education qualification of the concerned directors and subscribers. That is, they have cleared until 10th or plus 2 or BTEC or any master's degree. So that I am just asking all these requirements, keeping in view of the Part B application. These are all requirements which needs to be incorporated, which needs to be filled in at the time of filing the application. Next one is, if the director or subscriber is a NRE, then you should ask Sir, what is the duration of your stay in India individually by each and every director? That is, whether it is 2 years or 4 years, that is 10 years or so. So that we need to fill the form with these requirements. In continuation, we need to ask the individual proof of identity and individual address proof of each and every director come subscriber. What are the individual proofs? Voter ID or passport or driving license can be the individual ID proofs. And what can be the individual address proofs are telephone bill or electricity bill or bank statement. These three can be address proofs. And please note that these address proofs or ID proofs shouldn't be older than 2 months from the date of incorporation application. If it is more than 2 months, then there are many chances of getting our application getting rejected by the MCA. So, voter ID, passport or driving license, telephone bill, electricity bill or bank statement, ID proof and address proof of each and every person who is going to be incorporated. These needs to be collected, and please note that these needs to be self-attested by signing itself. By the directors or the members should sign the proofs and upload for scanning. Next, please note the area of occupation. If it is other than homemakers, whether they are doing any business or self-employed or employed, anything, I mean, according to their feedback, it needs to be filled in the application. Next one is a self-attested PAN copy of each and every director and subscriber should be, we should get self-attested. Without self-attestation, that PAN card can't be uploaded while filing the Part B application. See here, if you see the ID proofs or address proof, Aadhaar card is not a valid ID proof or address proof. If you just see these things. So I just want to enlighten you all that if you just view Aadhaar card, it won't be a sufficient valid ID proof and address proof. Aadhaar card is an optional attachment, but not a mandatory attachment for valid ID and address proofs. Next one, everyone should get a passport size photo of each director and subscriber. May not be hard copy what I am saying. It can be just a soft copy itself, because what we are going to do is just an upload. So we should get the soft copy of the passport size photo of either applicant. Next, we should get the director's individual mail ID and phone number, company's email ID and phone number. These should be perfect and these should be accurate, because in one of the applications which we are going to discuss in the coming slides, OTP will be generated. With the phone number and email ID, which we are going to give. So these should be perfect. Each and every director should be having a unique phone number and a unique email ID, apart from the company's mail ID and phone number. Then, what else? As I have already discussed, that Spiceplace Part B is offering a bouquet of services that are a kind of mandatory EPF registration, mandatory SIS registration, mandatory opening of bank account. A kind of a letter of authorization needs to be uploaded by signing by the proposed applicants. We'll just check the format. Yeah. This can be the format. I mean, a kind of authorization letter that so and so person of the proposed company is authorized to go for registration with EPFO, ESA. Is authorized to open a bank account for the relevant purpose after incorporation. Such kind of authorization letter needs to be uploaded here, which needs to be signed by the proposed directors. Next, going forward, the registered office proof needs to be collected. What is registered office proof? Any one of the following can be a valid registered office proof. That is, whether it is a conveyance or sale deed or municipal tax receipt or a lease deed or rent agreement or rent receipts, which is not older than 2 months. Please note, any proof which you are going to upload for Spice E+ should be older than 2 months. And a registered office address proof is optional in few states of India. For suppose in Andhra also, registered office without a uploading register of his address proof also. The companies get incorporated by just uploading the utility bill. What is utility bill? Yeah, we'll just discuss. Utility bill. Utility bill means that the premises, the required premises is in usage. That is the meaning of the term utility bill. What are the eligible utility bills? It can be either telephone bill, gas bill, mobile bill, or electricity bill. Any one of the following can be a valid utility bill proof, but keep in mind that this utility bill proof address should exactly match with the address resembled in the application. If there is any mismatch, then there are high chances of getting rejected. So please be very cautious while getting the utility bill proofs, and it is not older than 2 months, it should be collected. Next, then you should also collect NOC from the owner. NOC means a no objection certificate from the owner of the registered office. That is, if or suppose any proposed director is the owner of the registered office of the proposed company, then that owner should give a no objection letter that I have got no objection to use my premises as registered office premises of your proposed company. If such a kind of no objection certificate will be given, then it can be used for registered office address proof. I'll just show you what is the general format for no objection certificate. I hope this format will be in general with you all, but I'll just explain you. Yeah, it should be addressed to the concerned registrar ROC, stating that the owner has got no objection for utilizing the premises for registrar of his company in the name of the proposer company under incorporation. The owner should sign here, and it should be a valid NOC for getting a registrar of his proof. Moving forward, one should know the registrar of his jurisdictional police station. If the registrar of his is located in and around, for suppose in Gandhidham, in area of Gandhidham, the area jurisdictional police station needs to be mentioned in the application. So you should get ready with these requirements and all. Next one, before incorporating a company, you should have an idea of all the companies having this, which have the same registered office before, the same registered office which we are going to incorporate with now, because that list of companies needs to be attached with the application. Next, moving forward, the Spicy Plus has come up with mandatory opening of bank account. Then which bank, the name of the bank and branch needs to be filled exactly in the form. Which bank you want to open a bank account, in which branch you want to open a bank account, such kind of things we need to do it. Next one is, we should know who amongst the directors, who wants to be the managing director. It might be one or more than one also the managing directors, but you should know well in advance at the time of filling the application. It will be asking whether who is the managing director, whether he is just a director, normal director, or is he a managing director. So accordingly, the application needs to be filled. Okay, you will be knowing who is the director. Then a consent letter from such proposed director should be collected for scanning and attaching in the requisite form. What is the format of DR2? DR2 is a consent letter. Yeah, here it is, the DR2. This is a consent to act as director. Addressing to the proposed company, if he has the DIN number, he can fill up with DIN number. Otherwise, the DIN number can be left blank and he can fill the remaining details, that is PAN, phone number, nationality, everything. At the end, he should sign with a requisite ID and address, which we already discussed in my earlier slide. Then we need to see the number of shares and the amount already invested by the above directors in any other companies, because this is also one of the mandatory field in the application. That is, you should know that particular proposed person is interested in any other entity as a shareholder or a director. If the director has already DIN number, it's easy through the MCA portal to know whether he is a director of any other company. And we should also ask whether is he any shareholder, because if he is a shareholder, unless and until we see the public documents of each and every company, it is highly impossible to know in which company he holds shares. After knowing the shares, you should also mention the percentage of holding and the total amount of the capital of the concerned company in the application. With these requirements, if we just go the spice plus, we can just go in a smooth manner for incorporation. Yes, here, what are the linked forms to be filled along with spicy plus? EMOA, that is INC 33, EMOA, INC, EAOA, INC 34, sorry, EAOA, INC 34, URC 1. I have mentioned this URC 1 as a linked form only, though it is applicable only for conversion from some other entity into a private limited company, and it is not applicable to every private limited company. And as we are discussing with the fresh incorporation of private limited company, this may not be applicable for everyone. These are the linked forms: EMOA, EAOA, URC1, Agile Pro, application for GST, ESCIS, EPFO, opening a bank account. Everything will be dealt with Agile Pro, which shall we discuss in detail in the coming slides. And even practically, at the end, a declaration needs to be filed. Erstwhile, the declaration, we used to scan manually. Now, if you just fill all these forms, the INC 9 PDF will be auto-generated, which needs to be affixed with the proposed director's DSC and needs to be uploaded for incorporation. Friends, now it's time to proceed for incorporation. So we'll just move on with the incorporation procedure. Yeah, I just browse through MCA website. If you just log, as I said you earlier, it's a post login. Spice Plus is a post login service. I'm just logging with my credentials. Yeah, I just logged in with my credentials, and here in the dashboard, MCA services, wherein Spice Plus is there. Now, whether it is new application or existing application, it's existing application, because already we have dealt with Spice Plus Part A. Only after getting the Spice Plus Part A get approved, then we can proceed for Spice Plus Part B and other respective forms for incorporation. So we are rooted with existing application of Spice Plus. Here, these are all the companies which have dealt. Now for the demo purpose, I'm just going with this company wherein already Part A has been filled up. Now we'll just go with Part B. Don't see these forms, because these will be generated after Part B gets submitted. Now I just opened the Part B. It's loading. Oh, so I just came to the end of the application. Friends, this is one technical aspect. If it is a PDF form, we can scroll up and down, whatever the case may be. But as this is a web-based form, we should go up and down only one by one, one page by one page. I'm just going back for the first page. I'm now in the third page, I guess. Yeah, this is first page. Spice Plus Part B, first page of Spice Plus Part B, wherein the first one is whether articles of association has been entrenched. I'll just let you know what is the term entrenched means. I mean, after filling the Spice Plus Part B, I'll just show you the EAOA, which is in a fixed template, which has been already given by the MCA in a fixed template format, covering all the objects of the, covering all the articles which are applicable to the most of the companies. If you want to proceed with that template, then you can just click no. Otherwise, if you want to make any modifications or any other articles are not applicable to you, any fresh articles are applied to you well within the Companies Act, then friends, am I audible?
Yes, you're audible.
Yeah.
Yes.
There is a power of here. I just want to know whether any disruption is there. Yeah. Sorry for the interruption. Yeah. Now it is 5 plus part B, whether articles of association is entrenched or not. As I said you, if there is any modifications in the articles, not modification within the set template, article itself needs to be modified, then you need to click yes. Otherwise, you just click no and you can proceed. For the convenience sake of the users, I just click no here. And I will be covering the cases where the articles of association entrenched needs to be ticked yes. The next question is company, whether a company is having a share capital or not. Yes. We should see whether the company is having a share capital, or there are companies which doesn't have share capital and just by guarantee itself the company can be incorporated. And here I said that the company is having share capital. Third one, the most important one is capital structure. As I already discussed, the capital structure comprises of two parts, authorized capital, subscriber capital. Authorized capital. What is authorized capital? The ceiling, maximum amount. Here, I took the maximum, the authorized capital is 2 lakh rupees. And as the nominal amount per share I took is 10 rupees, then the number of authorized share capital is 20,000 shares. Of the authorized capital, how much is the subscribed capital? How much is the capital which you have taken, which you have purchased? Is 1 lakh rupees, which I have illustrated here. 1 lakh by 10, the nominal amount is 10,000 shares is a subscribed share capital. If you just fill the first page of this application, then you should click the save and continue button. I'll just go to the second page, wherein we need to enter the address details of the company. It's just a correspondence address, not a registered office address. Please note that it's not a registered office address, it's just correspondent address. I mean, to whom the incorporation certificate needs to be addressed, to whom the company prospectus or every other things needs to be addressed. That address is the correspondent address, which need not be matching with the registered office address. There might be chances that correspondent address might be a registered office address, but this won't be compulsorily be matching with the registered office address. If you just fill these fields, the address fields, here we have selected the city, Gandhidham. Gandhidham is in state of Gujarat, the pin code and all, and we have selected everything. We need to give, as discussed in our earlier slides about the requirements, we need to give the phone number and the email ID of the company. This should be perfect, which I said you earlier. This should be accurate because entire correspondence in future after incorporation will be dealt only with this phone number, your email ID. There are ways how to amend after incorporation, but prevention is better than cure. At this time itself, if you can give the accurate information, it will be perfect. Then see, the question here is whether address for correspondence is the address of registered office of the company. See, we have entered the correspondence address fields. Here it will be asking whether the correspondence address is matching with the registered office of the registered office or not. If you just say yes, then it will be your registered office. If you just say no, then I'll just tell you in future slides how a registered office needs to be uploaded after getting incorporated. That is within what time, which form needs to be filed and all. We can discuss in detail. As of now, I have kept as address of the correspondence is the same as the registered office company. As we have selected the state as Gujarat, the ROC of Gujarat is the jurisdictional ROC will be the ROC of Gujarat. Here a slight change can be done because in some few states like Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, there are more than one ROC. Then it should be crucial to select which ROC is applicable to you. If only correct ROC is set to you, it will be for lifetime of your company. The same ROC will be your applicable. Later on, we should make a request application to change the ROC. That is a procedural aspect. But here at the time of application itself, correct ROC needs to be selected. After filling in this second page, then by clicking save and continue, we can go with the third page, which is very important, which is very crux of the part B. I just want to take 2 minutes of your time for explaining in detail about this page, because this is very crucial, and depending upon this page only, the further pages will be enabled. Yeah, here it is. For convenience sake, I have just took two directors here, but the entire incorporation process will be done only with these two persons only. But only for this page, I just want to explain you with an illustrative example. For suppose there are 4 subscribers to a company, then that in the first column, the total number of first subscribers we need to enter is 4. If it is out of that 4, 1 is having a valid DIN and 3 are not having a DIN. So 1 plus 3 is the fields which needs to be filled. And both individual and non-individual, that is individual and other than individual, needs to be entered here. Second, out of the above, how many are the non-individual first subscribers needs to be entered here? Third one, in my illustrative case, out of the 4 subscribers, 2 are subscribers come directors. There are chances that subscribers can be directors. So the third row needs to be filled with 2, that is 1 with DIN and 1 without DIN. And number 4, you should mention the number of directors. I should mention, till now, in the first, second and third, you have considered subscribers. Fourth, only directors. The directors can be subscribers come directors, and directors need not be subscribers come directors. In my illustrative list, 4 subscribers, 2 subscribers come directors, and 3 directors. 1 is director, 2 are subscribers come directors. So 3 are direct, altogether 3 directors, of whom 1 is having DIN and 2 is not having valid DIN. 1 plus 2 is the case here. So I hope with this illustrate you, I think you will be able to understand this entire table. Later on, the video will be available in YouTube, so that you will be getting much more clarity if you just repeatedly see these videos. By just filling this page, we can just go to save and continue by clicking the next page, wherein as per the details which were given earlier, that is subscribers come directors are 2, 1 plus 1, 1 plus 1, and 1 plus 1, only those columns will be open here. See, particulars of non-individual first subscribers, as we have given 0 in the earlier page, here no columns have been opened. Second, particulars of individual first subscriber other than subscriber come director, as we have given the details of subscriber come director itself, so this thing needs not be enabled. The point D is particulars of individual first subscribers come directors. See in the earlier page, subscribers come directors, we have given 1 plus 1. So we need to enter the details of the directors according to the table of the earlier page. Yeah. If you click the edit button here, this person has have a valid DIN. So if you just enter this DIN number and click the prefill button, his name will be auto-populated into the form, and relevant fields needs to be filled accordingly. That is the gender, date of birth, nationality and all, and the designation, whether it is director, whole time director, managing director, it is a scroll down option. wherein if you select the relevant field, the relevant category should also be selected. If it is direct, here the case is director. So the category I have selected is promoter. At the time of incorporation, he is there. So he is a promoter. We should see whether he is an executive director or a non-executive director. Accordingly, the field should be filled up. Actually, Companies Act with just the terminology, who is executive, who is non-executive, who is director, whole-time director, nominee, this itself, we can take an entire separate session. As I'm restricting myself to incorporation procedure of private limited company, I'm not stretching my hands into those in detail. After filling these relevant fields, we should give as the mail ID of the director, the accurate mail ID, which we already took at the time of requirements, the accurate mail ID in the initial page, the first page, we have said that the 10,000 shares, that is 1 lakh is the subscribed capital. Out of that 1 lakh, as there is a 2%, how should I distribute? Here I am giving 5,000 equity shares, that is owned share of 5,000 to that to this person, Raghuna Sriram. 5,000 means nominal value, 10 rupees is 50,000. So accordingly, the subscribed share details needs to be filled. And at the time of requirements, I have even stated you that you should enter the number of entities in which the director have interest. Here, the exact case is here, the facts of the case is the director is nowhere. Is he a director? Nor he is a shareholder. So I have mentioned as number of entities in which his interest is zero. If there are any interested entities, then the requirements of the interested entity needs to be filled here, like percentage of shareholding, how much is the amount, designation, what all particulars as asked for it needs to be filled. After filling all the details of this director, we should click the continue button. Then we can fill the second director. This is edit option is enabled here. Yes, here the other director who doesn't have a valid DIN. Just a second. Organizers has the power went off. Just a second.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. I'm just opening my window. Yeah, the AC has been on. Yeah, sorry for the interruption. The power has been not there in. This is not just a corona pandemic, even the power of also will be there in Andhra Pradesh. It's very natural for us, no problem. So I just want to continue now. Yeah. We shall just continue with the other director's details who doesn't have a valid DIN. So after incorporation itself, this particular director will be getting a DIN number with the relevant details such as PAN and all. Friends, please mark my words that through SPICE E Plus, to maximum 3%, we can get the DIN numbers. So please mention this thing. We just fill the details, the first name, surname, father's name. These are all the permutations and combinations at the time of filling the application or at the time of applying for PAN of the particular person. What is the first name, last name, surname? These are all needs to be tried. These to be tried. So this is a technical difficulty. Once if we enter these names, we should enter the date of birth, gender, nation, which we already discussed. Here the place of birth, occupation type, self-employed. I mean, he has got his own business. What is this area of occupation? Whether what exactly his nature of thing is? Here I have selected others. So we need to just click the business. These are in common parlance, which doesn't have much importance. Education qualification, which we have took at the time of requirements, whether he is graduate or 10th. So these are all the required fields which we already taken earlier. So it will be very easy for us while filling the respective form. then we should enter the PAN number of the person. After entering the PAN number, we should click the verify details. Here I am just not clicking the verify details, because if I just click the verify details, it won't go to the next page now. After many permutations have come up with this name and all, if you just verify, if you click the verify details, the application at the top should be converted to green color. Only then it is a valid PAN, and with this valid PAN, a valid DIN will be generated by the MC at the post incorporation. We shall discuss here who is the, whether he is managing director, whether he is a promoter, what is this mail ID and all. These needs to be, these fields needs to be very important. And then, and later this address, which we have already collected, the address proof, valid address proof, which we have collected, that valid address proof should match with this address filled in the application. Address needs to be filled according to the phone number, the mail ID, whether the present residential address is the same as permanent residential address. Here, if you say yes, the fields will be automatically filled in the thing. Later, here, as I said, you should ask the duration of his stay. In my case, as a director, was in foreign for many years, was in outside India for many years. I here filled that he is for a period of 4 years, 6 months in India at the present address. Then, as we already taken, valid ID proof. Here I am just uploading the passport. Valid address proof. Here I am uploading a bank statement which should exactly match with the address. As we have 10,000 shares, that is 1 lakh is the subscribed capital. Already we have allotted 5,000 shares to earlier director. So as only two directors are there here, I just want to allot the remaining 5,000 balance shares, that is 50,000 subscribed capital, to this shareholder. That is 50,000 as the subscribed capital. And here also, we should see whether he is interested in any other entities or not. Just a second. Yeah. Here, the person doesn't have the DIN number itself. How could we expect that he is director of any other company? So that being a director is ruled away with. But there are chances that this particular person can be a shareholder of any other entity. Just by asking him only, we can come to know. Here, he is not a shareholder in any other company. So we need not fill these fields. And if he is interested, then the interested entity's details needs to be entered here, such as the percentage of shareholding, the amount of interest, the amount in the interested amount, the SIN number of the company, and so on. If you fill these application, the director details, then we can just proceed with the continue. I think, yeah, sorry, friends, this page has been locked off. Now there will be a ideal time of 5 minutes. If it doesn't do anything, it will automatically lock up. Yeah, I'm just logged in again. Yeah, Spice Plus. Yeah, we have completed this page now. So moving forward to the next page. Here, as we have already given our correspondence, our registered office address as Gujarat, it has automatically populated that our ROC is Gujarat itself. So according to the Gujarat, what is the stamp duty needs to be paid? Here, where the form, the 20 rupees is the stamp duty, MOA 100 rupees, articles 1000 rupees. Here in Andhra, it's MOA 500 rupees. In your state, it is much lesser. If you just prefill these details, the stamp duty needs to be paid will be enabled. After getting these, if we should enter the details of stamp duty already paid out of the said amount, out of the above amount, if any stamp duty is already paid, we should enter such details as well. After filling this page, if you just continue the next page here, we will be having whether what is the PAN number area code, what is the TAN number jurisdictional code, and all. As we already discussed, the Spice Plus is a offers a boutique of services wherein two items are mandatory issue of PAN and mandatory issue of TAN. The PAN and TAN will be enabled through Spice Plus Part B. Here we need to enter the jurisdictional area code of the particular company, AO code, range code, AO number of both PAN and TAN. Yeah, I know that you will be getting a doubt how to check the jurisdictional PAN and TAN details. Let me tell you. Yeah, if we just go to the tin.nsdl website, here you can go with PAN AO codes, non-international other than Mumbai region. In the NSDL website, the PAN AO codes will be enabled, which download us is in the Excel sheet. Yeah. Similarly, the TAN AO codes will be in the NSDL, tin.nsdl website. Same way, in the Excel sheet, we can know what is the jurisdictional AO codes for both PAN and TAN. After filling these details, here it will ask what is the source of income of the company, whether it is business or profession or capital gains, house property, other source and whatnot. If you select the business or profession, we should enter the business or profession code. I just already told you how to download the Spice Plus help kit. For your convenience, as I have already downloaded, I'll just show you. Yeah, which I already showed you, I think. As I have gone with the mining thing, number 14 has been selected here, which will be there in Spice Plus. Yeah, here, the business or profession code. Number 1 to 20. I mean, whether our business is medical profession, business, engineering business, as the case may be. As per the objects, we need to select in the application what is the required code here to be filled in the application. Yeah. If we just proceed, which we already discussed and which we already taken at the time of requirements itself, these are all the attachments. I mean, the utility bill of the company, the ID proof of the proposed director, the ID residential proof of the proposed persons, the ID proof of the first applicant, the ID proof of the second applicant, any other option such as PAN, the formats which we have discussed, everything needs to be attached here except MOA and AOA, because in the first page, in the first point, which I already told you, that if the articles of association is not entrenched, then these are all not mandatory fields. If it is entrenched, if the S has been kept, then without attaching this MOA and AOA, it won't be proceeding. I'll just discuss to you what are the cases where MOA and AOA needs to be done physically in PDF format. At the end, there will be a declaration by the director that I will be abiding the company's health rules, that I will be going as per the MCA, that the proposed name matches with doesn't match with any other name, it's not any offense to, like that the proposed director should sign with, should fill his details. In the same way, the professional, whether it's a chartered accountant or any other professional, needs to fill for certification these details, that he also should give the declaration that as per so and so Companies Act, that I am abiding, that I have seen all the proofs are valid, all the proofs are genuine. Like that, a professional also should certify. Once the application has been filled, if you click the pre-scrutiny button here, then the submit option will be enabled. I am not clicking here. Pre-scrutiny option, if I click, submit option will be enabled. Then after submit option, the PDF will be downloaded. And after this PDF, the respective MOA, AOA, Agile Pro, as the case may be, INCNI will all be generated. Just a second. Sorry, actually the power has been off. It's almost very suffocating in Andhra Pradesh, especially in the month of May. It's very hot here, almost we are into 50 degrees here. So only this much suffocation. Sorry for the disturbance. Yes. Now we shall proceed. As we have completed with part B, as and when the part B has been submitted, the other forms which are relevant, Agile Pro, AOA, MOA, INC9 has been enabled for us to fill the same. Yes. We'll just see what is this PICE MOA. The first one is all the fields will be auto-populated in PICE MOA as well. But here we need to select the applicable table, whether it is company limited by shares, whether it is company limited by guarantee, whether any other company, such kind of things needs to be selected here. Here, as we know that this company is limited by shares, table A is applicable. I have selected table A for company limited by shares. Accordingly, the name of the company is auto prefilled here. The ROC is Gujarat and the objects of the company. At the time of part A, we have given the objects in brief, just 3 to 4 lines. Now we have to detail the objects of the proposed company under incorporation. That is, what are the main objects? Here I have written what are the main objects, what are the ancillary objects in relation in or in furtherance to the objects mentioned above. That is all the main objects. These are all the ancillary objects. If you just fill the main objects and ancillary objects, and we should proceed to see what is the share capital of the company. As we already said, that 1 lakh is the subscribed capital. We should enter here the 1 lakh capital. That is divided into 10,000 shares with 10 rupees nominal value. We should end up with stating a declaration that we are the several persons whose names are set against our respective names. A kinds of declaration which needs to be given by the directors, proposed directors of the company, wherein the director details also needs to be entered here. The director's details and the professional details, that as if the everything has been signed before the professional, a professional should also certify the form. Here, after saving and submitting the form, the PDF will be downloaded. I'll just show you the PDFs also. Now the SPICE MOA has been completed. After MOA, AOA, as I said you, AOA is also almost a kind of template only. Nothing much to do. It is easy AOA, which is auto-populated by the SPICE Plus itself. So we should select the relevant table B. Already we have selected that company is limited by shares, so the relevant table will already be allotted to us. Later on, these are all the descriptions, these are all the respective fields in which check, if not applicable, we should keep a tick here. If there is any alteration, we should keep a tick here. Yeah, only generally in the first thing only, there are slight alterations will be there. That is a copy paste, I think, that the number of members shouldn't be crossing 200, that all the members are, that all the so-and-so that we will be transferring our shares restricted in as per the Companies Act. This thing needs to be thing. And next, we should highlight whether any violation. These are all the articles. As there is no change, I have not selected any tick mark here. Later on, at the end of the articles, we need to include who are all the proposed directors who needs to be entered into the articles. Those two names needs to be given. That's all. If the EAOA, at the end, similar to EMOA, the subscriber details needs to be given and it needs to be certified by a professional. Here also, if you submit the button, the PDF will be generated. After Spice Plus Part B, EMOA, EOA, then Agile Pro needs to be filled in. What is Agile Pro? Let me discuss. Though it was earlier before Spice Plus also, but it has come along with Spice Plus E form with this Spice E Plus. Earlier, Agile Pro used to be a separate E form. Here it is a web form included in Spice Plus. Here, Agile Pro is to be entered here. Agile Pro is a form which mandates GST number, ESIC registration, EPFO registration, professional tax registration for the state of Maharashtra, and opening of bank account. All these services will be routed through Agile Pro, which we already discussed, the bundle of services. Agile Pro will be dealing with these five kind of services. And my personal practical suggestion to all of the members is, through Agile Pro, don't go with application of GST number, because GST is very complicated in such a way that the requirements are very different from the incorporation requirements. So after incorporation, with the incorporation documents, if we just go through the GST website, we can apply for GST number at that time. And also, once we get the GST number, the compliances of filing the returns every month, are following the rules and all of the GST norms should be adhered to. So as of now, as I said to you earlier, that GSTN number, though mandatory, but only if it is applicable, only then it needs to be applied through Spice E+. The first one here is, it is asking whether do you want to apply for GSTN. Straight away, I said no.
Yeah.
Hello? Yeah. Straight away, I said no. Because I just want to apply separately through GST website after getting incorporated. My company getting with the incorporation documents, MOA, AON, I am eligible to apply the GSTN when the GST applicable to me. That is, there are conditions. When is GST applicable, when it is not, we will just discuss in detail. Here also the same, which we have filled in part B, that is state, ROC and all, which will be auto prefilled. After this page, we can go with the second page. There, we should enter what is the primary business activity, which we already entered in part A and part B. What are the brief objects of the company? And what is exact, after the primary business activity, what is the exact nature of the work? Here, my primary business is mining and exporting of granite, wherein exact nature is mining and exporting. So though might be both the same, but there is a slight difference. Here in the Agile Pro, the director details and all needs to be entered here. the DIN number, PAN number. Here I said you that phone number and email ID should be accurate so that relevant OTPs will be coming to the respective mail and phone number. Here I am not proceeding because OTPs and all, it's very time taking. If I just enter the phone number and email ID of the particular director, if I send OTP, the OTP will be communicated to him. Once you get the OTP, you need to enter the OTP. And before submitting this application, you should attach the passport size photo of the proposed director. Later on at the end of this page, as we already discussed in the earlier side at the time of requirements, that we should take the jurisdictional police station details, that is in where the ROC is from, what is the jurisdictional police station, and what are the, if as mandatory opening of bank account is mandatory through SPICE Plus, we should give the bank name, branch name and all, it should be entered here. As of now, Punjab National Bank, ICICI, Kotak, these are all the highlighted banks only got integrated with this SPICE E+. Maybe furthermore, some other nationalized bank like Andhra Bank and all needs to get enabled. There are some, didn't enter the OTPs, this page won't allow me to go to the next page. But the next page is just a declaration page. So it is easy for you to understand. So now, as of now, the SPICE Plus Part B, Agile Pro, MOA, AOA has been filled with. So as and when the forms have been filled, the PDFs will be available to download. Here is a cloud symbol, download, download, download. And even the INC9, which we used to manually scan earlier, INC9, now, with the particulars of Part A, Part B, and other details itself, INC9 itself is being generated in the PDF format itself. I'll just show you the PDF forms. Yeah. This SPICE Plus Part B, which we have filled all the details, and the PDF has been generated. Now, after the PDF getting generated, only thing which you need to do is at the end of the PDF, you should just check from the thing, and we should affix the relevant director details and the professional details. Affix the DSCs of the professional and directors and pre-scrutinize the form. I am ready to upload a SPICE Plus Part B. Like that, MOA, AOA. All the PDFs can be generated, and at the end, the directors and the professionals DSC needs to be affixed for the purpose of upload. Yeah, here. AOA also, Agile Pro, and here which I was talking, the INC9, a kind of declaration. If I just open this form, you will be getting an idea. Okay, this is the form which we used to upload manually by physically signing the document. This declaration of first directors are subscribers. This is just a declaration page that the proposed directors are going to declare that so and so documents are accurate, that I have filled all the details exactly, accurately, there is no mistake, a kind of a normal declaration. Yes. So coming back to the presentation, as we have generated the PDFs, now we are ready to upload these documents. Yes, these are all the EMOA, EMOA, EMOA means, which is a character, I mean, the main crush, main thing of the company, and articles are the rules and regulations which the company is being formulated. EAMBO is INC-33, E at INC-34 is EAOA. And moving forward to the question, as I discussed you, there are such some situations, some cases where MOA and AOA should be manually, physically uploaded. And these few are some cases, a kind of Section 8 company or any other thing. If a foreigner is adding to be a subscriber, then if he doesn't have a valid business visa, then all the documents of him, that is, excuse me, Arnes, I'll just take a few minutes time. I know the time is running out now. I'll just, there is slight disturbance here. Yeah, now it's paka. Yeah. The foreigners or non-residents, the document needs to be apostilled. What is meant by apostille? A kind of, in India, we'll be notarizing the document. In abroad, the embassy, the Indian embassy of the respective foreign nation needs to notarize those particular documents, such as PAN, other, whatever the proof which you are going to attach, needs to be notarized. That is, it needs to be apostille. Only by being apostille, not only just MOA, AOA, all the other relevant documents needs to be apostilled, and only then such forms can be uploaded for SPICE Plus for incorporation. Then, what is the word limit for writing objects? For main objects, 20,000 words is the word limit. And as I said you, the further and ancillary objects, 1 lakh characters is the word limit. Which we are Agile Pro, what is Agile Pro, which we already discussed practically through MCA website. This is theory, Agile Pro, application for goods and service tax identification number, employee state insurance corporation, plus employees provident for organization registration, plus professional tax registration, and opening of bank account is Agile Pro. As we discussed, Agile Pro is a web-based form. I'm just rushing the slides because there is a lack of time here now. And Arnes, I request, can I just continue for a few more minutes?
No problem, sir. You can.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah. The next question is registration for GSTN through Spice Plus is mandatory all over India? As I said, though it is mandatory, only it needs to be filled in the applicable cases. What are the applicable cases for GST registration? The business turnover exceeds 20 lakhs, then you go for registration. There are some exceptions, northeastern states or some hill station states, wherein the requirement of turnover is only 10 lakhs. For such kind of things, GST registration is mandatory when they crosses the threshold of 10 lakhs. Otherwise, 20 lakhs is a GST threshold. For services, 20 lakhs. For goods, 40 lakhs. There are n number of amendments in GST. That's entirely vast subject if we just go in detail with the GST. But I'm just going here only with the basic details. When is GST applicable? Whether if you want to go with e-commerce platforms like Amazon, Flipkart, like that, then GST is compulsory. Or if you want to make transactions interstate, when you want to sell interstate transactions, then even GST is compulsory. But considering this COVID-19 pandemic, there are some relaxations even for GST also. I'll just give you a brief of this GST. I know this is entirely different from the current topic, but I just want for the members' awareness, I just want to give a brief analysis. If for suppose March GSTR 3B return, the due date is 20th April. Without any interest until 5th May, it has been extended. Already 5th May has been over. Then until 20th May, only 9% interest will be levied. Until
after some kachra waste, we are talking.
Sorry, sir.
Okay, you can continue. It was by mistake, so by some.
Yeah, no problem. And after 20th May, it is 18%. So like that, there is a waiver in the interest, and after 20th May, there is a waiver in the late fee as well. That is a per day 50 rupees penalty. If that 25 plus 25. If it is a nil return, 10 plus 10, 20 rupees penalty. There is also a waiver for both a March return and April return until 19th June. There is a waiver and interest conditionally 4th, 19th, such kind of thing. And the turnover, if it is below 5 crores, if it is above 5 crores, these are the conditions, minimum conditions for GST relaxations amidst this COVID-19 pandemic. Next, as we said, the professional tax registration also is mandatory for Spicy Plus, but professional tax is only mandatory in the state of Maharashtra when it crosses 7,500 monthly salary. That is, we need to deduct as a professional tax 175 per month. And if it is more than 10,000, 2,500, that is 200 per month up to February for a period of 11 months, and 300 rupees for the last month as a professional tax needs to be deducted. Then, is registration for EPFO and ESI is mandatory through Spice Plus? Yes, it is mandatory through Spice Plus. As we already discussed Agile Pro form, how it is mandatory and all. But sir, what is EPF registration? When is it applicable? EPF registration is a kind of just a savings among various entities, a kind of government or private or public sector organization, any a kind of savings, and registration of EPF will be mandatory only within 1 month from the date of hiring the 20th employee of this entity. Before 20, EPF registration is not mandatory, but here Spicy Plus is mandating EPF registration. I'll just let you know what practically happening. Even ESIC registration also, if it is having more than 10 employees and if it is giving 21,000 per month, less than 21,000, then only ESIC registration is mandatory. But members, these all compliances are not required to be carried out in respect to EPFO or ESI until the company surpasses the threshold limit provided in the EPFO and ESIC provisions. So these all will be mandated only for registration purpose, but the applicable return filing and all needs to be done only if surpasses the respective act only. But practically, though the Spicy Plus is mandating these two, at the time of incorporation, these registration numbers are not getting generated by Spice Plus. And as and when the act prescribes, the respective act, ESA or EPF act prescribes, if we go with these incorporation to the respective website of the ESIC, then we can apply for fresh registration and we will be allotting the fresh ESIC or EPF registration. Then we have already discussed, is opening a bank account is mandatory? Yes, it is mandatory, and only these banks, which are stated in the slide, are integrated as of now with the Spice Plus. Maybe in further, some more banks will be added. Yeah, this one, URC one, which I already told, only is applicable for conversion from earlier entity into private limited company. As it is not relevant here, we are not dealing with this URC one. And INC9, as I said you, based on the details of the subscribers and directors details entered in part B, INC9 declaration will be auto-populated and available in dashboard for the users for affixing the DSC. Then what are the exceptions to INC9? Is still INC9 needs to be uploaded manually? Yes, these are the exceptions. If the number of subscribers or directors crosses 20, or if the subscriber doesn't have the valid DIN or PAN, then also INC9 should be uploaded manually by physically signing the INC9 declaration. These are all which we have discussed. Yeah, these are all the forms, the cloud symbols. Now these forms are ready to upload now. Okay, sir, I am ready to upload. But what is the sequence of uploading the linked forms to Spice Plus? The sequence is, which we already discussed in the earlier slide, first EMOA, next AOA, next Agile Pro, fourth one INC9. Before the four, all the four, Spice Plus Part B is number one, MOA is two, AOA 3, Agile Pro 4, INC9 5. Only if in this sequence, if you upload the forms, only then incorporation will be continued. Otherwise, there will be halted. The MCA won't allow you to proceed further. So, okay. Now, all the forms have been ready to upload, and we even attached, affixed the DSCs and attached the e-forms. Now, after affixing the DSCs and uploading, we can upload the Spice Plus for incorporation. On successful upload, you will be generated with an SRN number, service request number, and gets and displayed to the applicant. With this SRN number, you can just check the status. Okay, now whether my company is incorporated, when the company will be incorporated and not. During the explanation of the part B, I told you that the correspondent, if you just remember, if you enter the details of correspondent address, it may not be same as the registered office address or registered office. It may or may not be. In certain cases, if we keep as both correspondence address and registered office are same, but if we keep no, as and when the company gets incorporated, that is INC 22, please mark this. INC 22 is required to be filed within 30 days of its incorporation for intimating the registered office address to the ROC, respective jurisdictional ROC, INC 22. As we have successfully went for incorporation, I just want to tell you what are the few technical issues or observations and even suggestions while filing and filling these forms, Spice Press. Yes, first thing is we need to register the DSC, which we have took at the earlier and which we need to affix. At the time, we should register the DSC as a promoter, wherein the first name and last name needs to be entered, and it's a kind of formulations and combinations, which is time taking. This first technical issue which may arise for you. Next one, there is no automatic save option. That is, while filling the application, even if we complete the form, if we didn't save the content and if we logged off automatically, just see if the power gets off, logged off automatically, then I need to fill the form again. The respective page won't be, until I save that page, it won't be automatically saved. This is a major technical glitch. Next one, Spice Plus is divided into various subsectors. That is, only by filling one step, we can proceed to the next step. See, when at the time of Agile Pro, as I was not able to enter the OTPs, I was not proceeded to next pages. So such kind of technical glitches needs to be faced. So you need to fill the form only one by one, and unless and until if we get all the details, we cannot proceed with the Spice Plus forms. So for that, the requirements needs to be corrected much in earlier. Next, okay, after finishing Spice Plus part B, while downloading other forms, sometimes the download option will not be enabled. In those cases, we need to clear the data and the CAPTCHA and fill the, all the forms, which causes duplication of work. One more technical observation. After submitting the form, if there is any mistake in the form, there are chances of getting resubmitted. In those cases, only that particular form cannot be edited and for upload. All the other forms, that Agile Pro, MBO, AOI, all the forms need to be downloaded again, and the DSC should be affixed again, because all the forms, the affix, DSC affix dates should be the same. This point needs to be noted. And the last suggestion, it's a kind of technical suggestion. At the time of resubmission, suppose for any chances, your form has been sent back for any resubmission, then the error description, how you rectified the error, how are you uploading this form in just a white page, just a question and answer, so that it is a very easy for the restart to just go through the respective errors and approve our form. It is a easier way. So until now, we have discussed what are the pre-incorporation and what are the during incorporation, what are the steps to be done. I'll just discuss what are the steps to be done post-incorporation. That is, some small things which needs to be done, but due to some various reasons, many of us won't follow those steps, such as a commencement of business needs to be filed in INC 20A, AITRA needs to be appointed in ADT1, the share certificates needs to be issued in form SH1. What is commencement of business? INC 20A, without filing this commencement of business, you shouldn't commence the business. Actually, this was earlier mandatory for public limited companies, but from 2nd November 2018, every private limited company with share capital needs to apply with commencement of business, that is INC 20A, within 120 days. What are the attachments? You should attach the bank statement of the company. What is that bank statement? All the subscribed capital, that is as per our illustration, that is 1 lakh amount in the respective proportion needs to be dumped into the bank account of the company, and that statement needs to be attached to the INC 20A form, and only after the form gets approved you can commence the business, which is an STP form itself. As and when you upload, the form gets approved immediately without any pending for approval status. If there is any consequence of delay, yes, if there are consequence of delay, the registrar may initiate for a removal, or the company cannot borrow, or company cannot start the business and all. These are the common consequences, and there is late filing fees and all, which we can proceed. As due to paucity of time, yeah, I am just rushing through the slides. Auditor appointment. The company needs to appoint the first auditor within 30 days of the incorporation of the company, and the subsequent auditor can be appointed later. How will you appoint an auditor? That is through filing of Form ADT 1. Form ADT 1, it is applicable both for first auditor and a subsequent auditor. For the appointment of first auditor, though filing of Form ADT 1 is optional, but a board resolution needs to be passed within 30 days of the incorporation of the company, and first annual return, that is AOC4, needs to enter the SRN of ADT 1. In general practice, we will be entering Z89s as an SRN of ADT 1 of the first auditor, so that the forms can be, annual returns can be filed. But with respect to subsequent auditor, it is mandatory for the company to file ADT 1 within 15 days of appointing the auditor. Please note, friends, if you fail to appoint an auditor within 15 days of the AGM, of the subsequent AGM, then you are liable for hefty penalties. You should be ready to pay these late fees. It's not penalties, late fees. Only by paying the late fees only you can proceed further. Then one more post compliance is, you should issue the share certificates, that is SH1. The share certificate shares needs to be issued within 2 months from the date of incorporation. If you issue any additional allotment of shares, then within 2 months of the allotment of shares, SH1 needs to be issued to the members of the company. These are the SH1 format, and these are the fields which needs to be entered in the form SH1. Well, as we have completed the procedure for incorporation, I want to conclude the presentation with telling you the few procedures and compliances which are to be followed annually post-incorporation. That is, we should have board meeting within 30 days of incorporation. The company needs to be placing the board meeting, and it should conduct at least 4 board meetings in a financial year with a gap of not exceeding 120 days. Yeah, there are some relaxations which needs to be done. The next one is the first board meeting. The directors need to disclose their interest in Form MBP1. The last one is the gap should not be between 2 AGMs, not more than 15 days. Yes, there are certain relaxations amidst this COVID-19 pandemic. We'll just discuss these relaxations as well. These are all things, the DPT3, DR3 KYC, first time DR3 KYC, who needs to file this DR3 KYC annually, this thing, how to file ADT1, which we have dealt in detail. And at last, we should file the income tax returns of the company before 30th September every year. Don't miss out to filing income tax return. So amidst this COVID-19, 3 circulars has been issued by the AMC on 3rd May 2021 with respect to relaxation of additional fees for filing of form after due date, with respect to charge documents, with respect to maximum gap, which we already discussed. The maximum gap should not be exceeding more than 120 days, but there is certain relaxation through circular number June 8, 2021. We'll just discuss these details with the circulars in detail. Circular number 6, relaxation with respect to additional fees for filing of form. Yeah, if any due date of any form if falls between 1st April to 31st May, then there is a period of relaxation, and until 31st July, you are eligible to file the particular form. For example, ILP annual return, Form 11, needs to be filed before 30th of May 2021 for 2021 financial year. Now, as the due date falls between 1st April to 31st May, it was postponed to 31st July. Till 31st July, without any late fee, I am eligible to be filing this Form LLP 1. But this circular doesn't applicable to certain charge documents such as CHG 1, CHG 4, CHG 9. These all should be kept in mind. But there is one more circular for CHG 1 and CHG 9. That is circular 07/2021, wherein this circular can be divided into two parts, part A and part B. That is, if the charge creation is before 1st April, then from 1st April to 31st May, this period won't be counted for creation of charge. That is 120 days period. Within 120 days, the form can be filed. This 120 days period won't be calculated for 1st April to 31st May. Similarly, in part B, if any charge creation document or modification needs to be filed between 1st April to 31st May, even then there is a relaxation that this period won't be eligible to be counted for the purpose of charge creation. This is a particular kind of relaxation circular given to charge documents by MCA. The third circular is the time gap between the two board meetings, which you have discussed earlier as 120 days, but a relaxation for first quarter, that is April, May, June 21, and July, August, September 21, there is a relaxation that it can be extended up to 180 days. But those board meeting due dates should be there in the first and second quarter of the 21-22. I'll just let you know with an example. If the first board meeting has been held on 1st April, and the second board meeting on 27 September, then the same would not be a violation, because though it has crossed 120 days, as the dates are falling within this quarter, within these two quarters, there is a relaxation for which it is not a violation. So before I just conclude, I just want to say you this thing. These initiatives taken by the government from the last are significantly very important, and it has even fastened the procedure. Even in 2 or 3 days also, the company getting incorporated. This formerly was a very tedious process that involved months of toil and labor. And with this presentation, thanks to the organizers for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Thank you, friends. It's up to you. Sorry for taking the time. Organizers are requested to proceed.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for your wonderful session and letting us on this topic. And you have briefly addressed, detailed on all the topics, and all the points.
Thank you.
How to incorporate and post incorporation.
Yeah, due to the paucity of time only, I rushed through some of these slides. Sorry about this thing. And there is a power up here. So sorry, so only frequent interruptions have come.
No, we appreciate you all. Thank you. Thank you. If anyone has query, then they can ask.
Yeah, please.
If anyone has query, then they can kindly unmute themselves and ask the query.
Yeah, at the end of my presentation, I've given my mail ID. So if any person wants to ask any query, you can drop a mail to me. So within 1 or 2 days also, I can just reply to that mail as well.
Since there is no query with any participant, so it's saying that you have well addressed to all the members. So there is no query.
Thank you.
There is one query in chat box. You may read it.
Yes, okay.
Posted by Chandra Sekhar ji.
Can you please read out that query, because
under
the chat box has been disabled for me here.
Okay, can no you please issue. Read I will read it. under Rule 16(1)(m) for proof of ID, PAN card, and unique identification number can be accepted. In such a case, can we attach PAN card and other is ID proof?
Yeah. If there is no PAN card or the PAN card has been misplaced, Aadhaar card can be replaced, but subject to notarized by the official authority. That is, he should be notary officer. Only the notarized Aadhaar card can all be a valid proof in place of PAN. But at least PAN number is valid. PAN number is must. Without PAN number, incorporation can't be done. Hope I address your query.
Yes, thank you. Yes, got it. If anyone has further query, then they can ask. Okay. So thank you everyone for formal vote of thanks. Going to the end of the session, for formal vote of thanks, I would like to request Puri Mehta from Bhuj branch for vote of thanks. Over to you, Puri Madam. Puri Madam, we are not audible. Kindly. No, we are not get audible. Kindly turn. No.
I'm already unmuted.
Yes. Now you are audible.
Okay. A very good evening to all of you. On behalf of Bhuj, Gandhidham, and Anand branch of WIRC of ICI, I would like to thank you. Today's eminent speaker, CA P.V. Satish Kumar sir, for such a knowledge sharing session. Sir, we are really very grateful to you for sparing your valuable time for the great benefit of our members' knowledge and regarding the very relevant topic with a relevant subject, how to incorporate a private limited company with pre and post compliance along with recent MCA relaxations. Sir, really, we are very thankful to you. I would also like to thank our today's chief guest, C.S. Srinivasan Joshi, sir, Chairman of Corporate Laws and Corporate Governance Committee of ICI. I would also like to thank all the members who had participated in today's seminar and enriched themselves by much needed knowledge in present scenario. Thank you once again, all of you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone,
for this wonderful opportunity. Bye.
Thank you. Goodbye. Good night.